Tanya High is ITV's new high-octane drama, with music by Gary Barlow. Set in a fictional performing arts school, the series follows the students of Britannia High. Danny, Lauren, Claudine, Bibi, Lola, and Jez. This is the story of how the six stars of Britannia High were discovered and the year-long journey to create this exciting new series. November 2007. Unwritten, with no characters and no music, Britannia High really was in its infancy when the search for its talented young cast began.
What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Maybe This Time from Cabaret.
Leading the search were creators of Britannia High. Arlene Phillips, the creative director of choreography.
I don't want anyone to be average at anything. This is an extraordinary show. I want them to be exceptional, and that's what I'm looking for.
And theatre producer, David Ian.
It's so different than anything I've ever done. We've got to get great recording artists and great TV performers.
Creating the brand new soundtrack to Britannia High were Gary Barlow and a team of the world's top songwriters.
I think we've fallen on something pretty special here. This is fun for me. I wake up dreaming of stuff like this.
Joining Arlene and David in the search for those singers for Gary was legendary music producer Chris Neal.
He's great, he's quirky, his voice is classic rock singer.
Hi, Pixie. Come on in.
There's a lot of people in here.
With such high-profile industry heavyweights creating the show, they were a tough audience to please.
No voice, no dance.
Oh, God, no.
OK, it's a no.
As the stars didn't just have to sing, they also had to act well enough to hold a story.
He thinks I'm a joke.
Good, Jasmine. Looks great on here.
And demonstrate they were able to dance to Arlene's high standards.
Throw yourself into it. I want to see you go more off balance.
We're not looking for Mr. and Mrs. Ordinary. We're looking for triple threats. They've got to be able to sing, they've got to be able to dance, they've got to be able to act, and they've got to sort of burn through the screen. They've got to be stars.
After a nationwide search of top performing arts schools, just 140 were selected to audition for Arlene, David and Chris.
It's not an amateur search, if you like. This is unashamedly looking at professionals for a professional role.
As this was the start of the process, none of the characters had yet been written. So, if someone had star quality, they could be considered for Britannia High.
Maybe this time, I guess I did not see.
The talent was varied.
Any chance of him opening his mind today?
Oh, no.
He's closed it right down.
But as this was a major television drama, the one skill that was non-negotiable was the ability to act.
Why acting? Okay, well, why acting?
If they couldn't act, then there was no way into Britannia High, regardless of their other talents. But it was these other talents that were causing some conflict.
Everybody's fighting hard for their corner. You know, you've got Chris Neal really fighting hard for some fantastic recording voices.
Darling, I've been waiting for you.
His voice is what Britannia High is all about.
And then you've got Arlene wanting, you know, Darcy Bustle to walk in the room as quickly as possible.
OK, music. Not even an option. So eventually we're going to have to find some people that dance, because they can't all not dance.
Having choreographed and directed hundreds of West End and Broadway shows, no one was harder to impress than Arlene Phillips.
She's a triple threat.
Yes.
Can't sing, can't dance, can't act. I guess I'm quite dismissive at auditions. I expect the same standard I get in America. When you audition in America and they're professional through and through.
They tried every single style of dance to impress her, from tap to ballet, and some just tried.
What music are you going to dance to?
Grease.
We're seeing some of the worst dancers I've ever seen in my life, quite frankly. I couldn't even raise the energy to tell her to put something into it. They dance and it has nothing to do with the music. I just can't bear to see anybody else shuffle around out of time to the music. Thank you. Moving on.
To show the casting team the standard she was looking for, Arlene brought in professional dancer Daniel Uppel.
When I watch Daniel dance, I feel electricity running through my body. That's what I want to see as part of Britannia High, these extraordinary dancers.
One person that should impress Arlene is 17-year-old Zizi Strallen. She has a dancing heritage.
I probably remind you of my auntie, Bonnie Langford. We smile the same, apparently, and we've got the same eyes. My family is totally in show business.
With Zizi, she's probably the best young dancer in London, there's no question. She's from a family of great dancers. If she can produce the goods, then I want her as part of Britannia High. These 16, 17-year-olds with incredible talent are what Britannia High is about.
Head of music, Chris Neal, was also expecting exceptional talent.
What I'm looking for is people that will record great, but also are naturally good.
My racing heart is just the same.
We found a few diamonds here, seriously uncut diamonds, but really, really good people vocally. And I'm looking forward to wiping the dirt off and getting it really, really, really good.
Oh, that's the real thing, isn't it?
It's the real deal.
Somebody better show me how before I fall any deeper. Think you better leave right now.
Fabulous, well done.
The boys impressed Chris. But finding girls was more difficult.
Billy Ray was a preacher's son. When his daddy would visit, he'd come.
Sorry.
Can't you try singing in a group? Billy Ray was a preacher's son. When he down and down and down, down below. Yeah?
Okay.
One, two, three, and.
Billy Ray was a preacher's son, and when his daddy would visit, he'd come along. When they gathered round and started talking, then...
Do you want the lyrics?
No, I know the song, I just can't do it with piano.
The music for Britannia High was being created by Gary Barlow and some of the world's most respected songwriters. They were used to writing for the biggest names in the industry. So Chris Neal simply had to find the best.
It's time to try.
But at the auditions, the girls were struggling.
In gravity, I think I'll try defying gravity, and you can pull me.
It wasn't looking hopeful until Georgina Hagen walked in.
Story of my life, searching for the right.
You see a lot of people that, you know, are just okay and just ordinary, and then occasionally somebody stunning walks in.
And I know that he knows I'm unfaithful.
At just 16 years old, she was one of the youngest to audition for Britannia High. Georgina's family work in the entertainment business, and Arlene has known them for some time.
I can see him dying.
I've worked with her family. Her father's a musical supervisor, her mother's in Sound of Music. Nobody ever gets anything because they know me. They get it because they're talented. Georgie, in Defying Gravity, I think we've got the music. Can you do the big belt bit?
No wizard that there is or was is ever gonna bring.
I just heard the person before me singing Wicked, hitting some top F notes. It's a bit daunting when you have to go in after that.
I really, really want this so, so much. I can't explain.
Dancing through life. Another discovery was 19-year-old Matthew James Thomas.
There's going to be a lot of people doing the same thing, and hopefully I'll be different.
He narrows his eyes, and you can see that. Any chance of him opening them today? Oh, no, no, no. He's closed them right down.
Matthew impressed everyone on the panel.
His voice is something incredibly rare. He has a show voice with soul.
Even Arlene.
And he can dance.
Oh, and he can dance. Must be time for a sandwich.
And so it was decision time. Over 140 of the best young talent from across the country had been seen over 5 days of auditions. But only 40 young people were considered talented enough to have the potential to be in Britannia High.
The people that we'd like to see again for a recall are...
It's easy. Dawn Sivright, Georgina Hagen and George Ewer, Ed Sheeran, Sophie Powles, Sean Williams, Lanre Malaolu and Matthew Thomas.
I feel absolutely ecstatic. I just can't explain it.
Very surprised, actually, because I can't dance.
Zizi shares her surprise with her auntie, Bonnie Langford.
Hi, Barn, it's Zee.
Hello, darling.
Hi. I'm all right. They've given a recall. And I'm going to Manchester in a week and a half.
This is good news. I'm very happy, very happy.
So Matthew, Georgina, Zizi, Sophie and 36 others were in with a chance of landing one of the six starring roles in TV's most eagerly anticipated new drama. Now, all that stood between them and a part in the show was a gruelling two-day workshop in Manchester.
What's going to happen? What's it going to be like? What are the people going to be like? What are they going to make us do?
It's now December 2007, Manchester. After a gruelling first-round audition, just 40 young performers were considered talented enough to make it to the next stage, the Britannia High Workshops.
My adrenaline's pumping and you know what to think and what to expect.
The whole week's just been building up to this one moment and like you don't want to ruin it.
My tummy's a bit like churning over.
Good morning, everybody. It's 40 of you standing here from all the best drama schools and stage schools throughout the country. What we need are people that can be stars on the television, stars in the pop charts, and stars in arenas. And I think it's got to be the biggest opportunity ever for performers of your age. Enjoy it, work hard, fingers crossed.
Having previously only spent 5 minutes with each of the 40 auditionees, the casting team would now spend 2 days working intensely on dance with Arlene Phillips.
What I want to see is attitude, work, determination.
Vocals with head of music Chris Neal.
Can we take it up a little bit? I just want to see what...
And acting with producer Gareth Phillips, casting director Janie Fraser and executive producer Kieran Roberts.
We've got some brilliantly talented people.
They wanted six young performers that were triple threats. Could sing, dance and act. But as they worked more closely with the selected 40, it was clear that very few were good at all three. In choreography, Arlene had separated the students on their dancing ability.
You need to get down, get dirty, get funky.
From the experienced to the very inexperienced.
You know when you come back to go click, click, do you step back on your left foot?
We've got a very mixed bunch here. We've obviously got some people I'm going to see who can't dance at all.
So how many of you have danced before?
With some admitting to no dance experience at all, it was up to Arlene to see who had the potential to learn routines.
What I'm looking for are some extremely talented dancers. Dancers who are so brilliant that young kids can aspire to them.
In this room today, I have seen so many talented people, and I'm one of the last 40. I'm quietly confident because any job I go for, I go with the intention of getting it.
As each episode in Britannia High featured difficult choreography, some were clearly going to struggle.
Ed hasn't a clue what he's doing, but he's trying.
I'm just trying to really get it in my head. I think I messed up as well. I got kicked in the face by accident.
What I'm looking at now is, if kids can't dance, what else can they do? If they can't do something else, thank you. You're going home.
But performers like Ed couldn't be ignored, because what he lacked in dance ability, he more than made up for in his musical talents.
He's great, he's quirky.
And I don't care if you're lost, it's in our hearts, we both know that.
His voice is classic rock singer.
Absolutely. I'd be interested to see what the acting guys have got to say, though.
Acting and dancing, who knows?
But he's 16, is the real thing.
He's 16, you know, I'll be signing him anyway.
It was going to be a tough 2 days for the casting team, as they had no idea who was shining and who was faltering in which areas. All they knew is who they liked.
Oh, you're good.
I want to know more about her. She's a really good actress.
Sophie Powell's impressed in acting, but in the music room it was a different story.
Boy, I'm in love with you.
At this level, it becomes patently obvious who's in on their acting and dancing abilities and not their singing abilities.
I tried. If it was successful, I do not know, but I don't know.
We have to move from the OK to actually very good and excellent, yeah.
Chris Neil was looking for a very specific vocal style. Each of our six stars of Britannia High would have songs written just for them by Gary Barlow and a crack team of renowned songwriters.
My job today and over the next couple of days is essentially to find the great pop singers. A lot of the academies, they churn out show singers. Only one who ever teach me. And that's not what Britannia High is about. It's going to be a pop show. Cabaret singer. Show voice. So I'm looking for natural singers, obviously good tuning, good intonation, and someone who can convey the emotion. Someone basically you believe.
16-year-old Pixie Lott is hoping she can land a role in Britannia High.
It's just such a great opportunity that it'd just be stupid if anyone didn't want it.
Two, three, and
leave her.
To find that kind of maturity in a voice that young is very special.
Leave her alone.
But Pixie had competition. Georgina Hagen was also impressing Chris.
Georgina is a natural singer, and I got her to sing the song Leave Her Alone, and there's one note in it that somebody, whoever sings it, has to sing it with great control.
Leave her, you gotta know when.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I found my singer.
The auditions were relentless, and cracks were beginning to show.
I can't bear it when good dancers are lazy.
She wants it like, bah, bah.
You've got a spine, use it!
She wants more, basically.
Hello, like, no chance.
Oi!
I think she needs a huge amount of work as an actress.
Zizi Strallen is from a famous family of professional dancers, and she was one of Arlene's favourites at the first round auditions.
She understands all the nuances of the movement.
But Zizi had very little acting experience.
I don't know what it is with you. I always feel like I'm on my best behaviour. I felt like I did my best with the acting. And then today, it just didn't go as well.
The pressure of learning a new skill was starting to affect her performance in the dance studio.
Make sure those pirouettes are really sharp. In this, you can outdance everybody, and you know you can, and you can perform it.
And then Arlene said, was like, come on, you can give it a bit more attitude. Like, I expect more from you.
Did I give enough? What? Did I give enough?
Yes, of course you did. Of course you did.
I really, really, really do want this. And, yeah, I just felt this morning, I thought, oh, God, I've blown it now.
And Zizi wasn't the only one desperate for a role in Britannia High.
Every step you get further, the more you want to go.
We're all realising now that this is about getting a job.
We're here for a reason, and that's to get the part.
I just want to have a part in this show.
It would mean a lot for me to come back tomorrow. I have tried really hard today.
Over the two-day workshop, the casting team had tough decisions to make.
If you didn't hear your name, it's not for you this time around. Please leave us now.
And for some, the dream of a starring role in Britannia High was over.
I just felt like I let myself down anyway, so I wasn't like 100% today, so it's fine. I totally understand.
I've had a bigger knockback than this. I nearly got Billy Elliot. And I'm cool, I'm fine.
And you're working with such big names and just to not get through, just think, I've lost out on a big opportunity, but what can you do? Just finish now.
From 40 that had been initially put through their paces, just 16 remained. Six lead roles were on offer. But to land one, they would have to convince the casting team on their final challenge, the studio screen test. Here they would perform a specially written scene on camera in a television studio and work with newly appointed series producer of Britannia High, Brian Grant.
Casting is one of the most important things you do. If you don't cast it properly, you can never recover. They also have to have this little magical ingredient that you can't put your finger on, that the audience will want to see them in their living rooms every week because there's something special about them.
As Brian directed the young performers, the rest of the casting team watched from the studio gallery. As this is a TV drama, how each of them performed on screen was crucial.
I don't know what it is about you, but I always feel like I'm on my best behaviour.
Sophie Powles is the only performer to have made it this far without any formal training.
It's the day of reckoning today. I'm just trying not to think about it, because when I do, I'm like, oh my God.
Sophie works as a part-time lifeguard in her hometown of Cleethorpes, but has always harboured an ambition to be an actress.
I think when I was little, I was going to go to drama school, live in London, be
be a star. And then you get older and you realise life's not that simple. If you want something, you have to work for it.
She's never attended drama school.
I think sometimes my mum and dad felt bad because they were like, we're sorry we can't afford it, we're sorry we can't do this and do that, but they've supported me so much through my life.
But on screen, Sophie's natural acting ability captivated the team.
I think I love you.
She's absolutely lovely.
She's very, very special. Yeah.
Other girls looking to land a lead role were Pixie and Zizi.
I'm not bothering revising.
I'm not being a bitch, yeah, but I saw Candice yesterday and she has got fat.
Arlene loved Zizi's dancing and Chris Pixie's voice. But now it was all about their acting.
If we were casting just drama, she wouldn't make the grade. That's my feeling. But I completely understand that she has these other talents.
We need to take our characters on pretty major journeys where each one of them is going to discover something quite big about themselves or who their friends are.
Yeah, that's the problem for me. I'm not sure she's got do anything else.
With the final auditions well underway, a visitor turns up to the studios. Take That are appearing in concert in Manchester. Gary Barlow, who's writing the soundtrack to Britannia High, has come to take a look at the potential singers he could be writing for.
I'm here to just see where they're up to. I've been getting reports every 3 days, basically, on how many kids they've got and who they're excited about. Obviously, I'm looking for good voices, but also, obviously, it's a show where they need drama and they need movement, so, you know, let's see what we've got. Sir Ian.
How are you, son?
Sir Ian.
Good.
You OK? Hi, Arlene. How are you doing?
You're cracking singers, Gary. It's cracking singers.
Have all these been to, like, 3 or 4 auditions?
Yeah. They've all been through the mill, yeah.
And these are the ones that are left.
As they sing one of Gary's songs, none of the performers have a clue that the man himself has been watching and listening. Tell me how I'm gonna wake up
without you. That sounded unbelievable. Who was singing that? Well, hello. Oh my God, nice,
hello.
To meet you.
Nice to meet you.
How are you doing? Hello, everyone.
Hello. Hello.
It sounded incredible.
Oh, Gary Barlow turned up and everyone gasped. And I was just like... Oh my God, and I melted.
It's like he came out of nowhere. I'm like, oh my God.
Pixie, do you want to do the verse as well?
Yeah. Okay. There is nothing but you.
If everything was ever new. I mean, it was weird singing a Gary Barlow song in front of Gary Barlow. But yeah, it was really good to meet him.
Thank you.
Fantastic. I was worrying that I was going to get here today and be going, yeah, it's great, everyone, and going home a bit disappointed, but I think we've got 3 fabulous voices. Matthew. If I was 30 seconds younger, he's got a good voice, hasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. He also looks really good on screen, actually, doesn't he? Be calmer, no better. Georgine, brilliant. There'd be nothing more to do if every day strong. Was strong voice. But I also think there's a star here, Pixie. If you want your big money song in the final episode, that's the girl. She's impressed me a lot. I know they're still questioning her acting, but I think they will be stupid if they let her go. So, good day.
But the final decision doesn't lie with Gary. As he heads off to prepare for his show that evening, it was left to the casting team to decide who, out of the remaining 16, would be cast in Britannia High. The young performers had done all that they could. All that was left now was to wait.
I am absolutely shattered.
You know, everyone in there has done their utmost and done everything they can to get into this cast.
The thing that's really on my mind is that, you know, you never really know whether they like you.
It was a critical time. And the team were not about to make such important decisions quickly. They had to find performers that had all 3 talents.
This one, you can go, fantastic dancer, fantastic singer, fantastic actress. Yeah. This one, you go, well, she's sort of all right at everything.
If you're even thinking her, she has no musical timing whatsoever.
We are sitting here, and knowing they're talking about us in the next room, I just need to know now whether it's a no or a yes.
If I don't get in, I'm just going to be...
You know, we're looking for very special people here. Yeah.
It's all a bit too much for me. All this waiting around. Oh, just ready now to find out.
She's such an exciting, lovable actress. Yeah. That
if she couldn't do anything else, we'd still maybe want to see her in the show.
Is she a kind of character that you'd, as a character, forgetting the deficiencies, mm-hmm. would you want to see her every week?
Finally, after 2 hours, the team are ready to give their verdict.
I've always like talked about how much pressure I put on myself, but how I have to live up to like other people, you know, in my family that have done really well. And that's why I get emotional, and nobody understands how, like, how much I really, really want it. You know?
I can truthfully tell you that we have not been able to cast to our completion and to our satisfaction out of this process. Where we have got to is that amongst you, there are four that we have a few more question marks about before we can decide. And there are two of you that are going to be offered a part in Britannia High right now. The four people we need to work with further are Sophie Powles, Pixie Lott, Rochelle Neal, and ZZ Stratton. There are two amongst you that we're going to offer a part in Britannia High right now. Those two people are Matthew Thomas and Georgina Hagen.
Georgina and Matthew were cast and the first stars of Britannia High.
I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
It's all paid off. I can't believe it.
I'm proud of myself.
I am so glad that I'm through with Matt.
I am going to phone my mum the minute I get out of here. And I hope she isn't driving or something.
We found two extraordinary people. I feel very strongly that unless we find people as exciting, we don't say yes.
For the rest, they'd given their all, but they hadn't made the grade this time.
I don't think anyone could say that they didn't want the part and they weren't hoping to get the part, because everyone wants it as much as the next person.
A lot of the time you get close to something, but I never get to the like final stage. I'm not feeling it's not good for the soul.
December 2007. After putting 40 young performers through a gruelling audition process, only Matthew James Thomas and Georgina Hagen have made it into Britannia High.
Oh, my God!
Can't believe it. I can't believe it.
But the casting team were still undecided on four other potential cast members, Pixie, Zizi, Rochelle and Sophie.
It's not a question of whether they're talented, it's whether they're absolutely right, and as youngsters, whether they're right now.
After working with them further, the producers decided that there was to be no role in Britannia High for Zizi, Rochelle or Pixie. Although Pixie had impressed Gary Barlow, the casting team felt that her acting ability could not sustain a major role in a television drama.
I've done everything that I could have done and they still don't think I'm right, so there's nothing more I can do.
They got so close and then it was like, oh no, sorry, we don't actually want you, and I'm not happy finally, but I've just got to get on with life now, haven't I?
But for Sophie Powles, it was a different outcome.
There's something very, very quirky about her. Our problem with Sophie is we don't quite know what to do with her.
You have inspired us to kind of come up with an additional character.
It will be written about you and for you.
That's quite exciting.
We'd like to offer you a part in Britannia High, if you're willing to accept.
Yeah, I'm willing.
Just for once, I have people to say, you know what, you are good. It's just blooming ace.
My dad is going to be so proud of me.
As he should be.
The future for me is a bit blooming exciting, but I've got a lot of hard work to do now.
So Sophie joins Britannia High as an additional role, leaving the casting team with four more lead stars to find. January 2008, and after the Christmas break, the search for the missing stars of Britannia High continued. But now, time was against them. In just a few weeks, Gary Barlow would start writing songs specifically for the cast of Britannia High. Without the full cast, the soundtrack could be in jeopardy.
No matter how good our song is, it lives or dies by the voice that's on there. So it's so important, those voices are essential.
We're hoping that amongst all the people that turn up today, there'll be some singers who can dance and act.
So it was a new year and a new search. This time, it was an open audition.
It's hit and miss an open call, you don't know what you're going to get.
Hundreds turned up for their chance to be one of the Britannia High six. Anyone could apply, as long as they were exceptionally talented and looked 16 to 18 years old.
And obviously you're 29, so we're not going to be able to see you or do anything with you.
This time the casting team were being brutal. If they didn't have the right look for the show or experience, then they didn't even get to audition.
Okay, I don't think you're for us, thank you very much.
Open auditions can be very disheartening because you see hundreds of people who want to do what you're offering and they're just not right.
You're not for us, I'm sorry.
I trained at Mountview.
Okay, you're not for us, I'm sorry.
Just a little bit of professional training, but not...
You ask them then to tell you their name and where they train and you just get this mumble. Well, you want to act in a television series and you can't actually tell me your name so I can hear it. It's not going to happen.
No. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Mark, go home.
You're not for us, I'm sorry. Yeah, I don't think you're for us. Thank you very much.
I'm Sophie Holmes. I'm training at Leigh Theatre Arts.
Okay, Sophie, you can go down there if you like. Thank you.
Only if they looked good. Then they were tested on just a few simple steps to see if they had the potential to dance.
Step and go for your pirouette! You are never going to be part of Britannia High. Step and go for your pirouette.
If they got through dance, then they had to act.
You're at the front tapping better than Izzy. She's done West End.
And sing.
My heart and I will love you.
We've got better.
But as the day wore on, it became increasingly obvious that from the hundreds that had initially turned up to audition, the number of potential stars were diminishing rapidly.
You know you're not as good at dancing as me.
Well, it's hard to tell. You're always still in the spotlight.
I am not.
You can read the phone book better than I can, really. Onwards.
No one could reach them.
Totally.
As one of Britain's busiest choreographers, Arlene had other commitments and had to leave the producers to continue their search alone. So, unfortunately, she never got to see the first audition by 21-year-old Sapphire Elia.
Because everything's gonna be all right.
The producers wanted to see Sapphire again later that week, but there was a problem.
I can't make Wednesday and Thursday. I'll be filming in Madrid.
The only way show creators Arlene Phillips and David Ian would be able to see Sapphire would be on video. And most crucially, Arlene would need to see how well she could dance. So her assistant, Georgia, put her through her paces.
Stop on seven, back on eight.
With limited time to get the routine perfected, it was a big ask for Sapphire.
I'm more of a singer and an actress, so if I do get a part in it, it's going to be really, really strenuous for me with the dancing.
But she would have to wait for David and Arlene's verdict on her audition. Mid-January, London. And just 40 people had been shortlisted to be seen by Arlene and David.
I'm just back from holiday, so I'm hoping today that we're going to get the final parts cast. It's crucial.
David, Arlene and the producers still needed to find four more stars, and time was against them. In less than a week, Gary Barlow and a team of the world's top songwriters would be expecting the full cast to work with at the recording studios in Bath.
We're all under a little bit of pressure because of, you know, it's a massive amount of talent down there and we can't get all that talent together again.
If performers weren't cast today, the whole production could be in jeopardy. Having already cast Georgina Hagen and Matthew James Thomas, the producers now had to find talented performers that would fit alongside them.
We have to be as excited about another four or five actors. We're going to be as strong as our weakest link, and our two strong links are phenomenal.
Arlene managed to make the briefest of visits, but as ever, she was sure to make an impression.
Do it again. I know we are going to have to see more people. It's like cherry picking.
She watched Sapphire.
Absolutely exquisite.
They can say what they like.
This is it.
And gave her verdict on the rest of the talent the producers had found.
His problem is he could almost be Matthew. There's no way he looked remotely in the same age bracket.
Arlene had spoken. It was now a tough decision that lay ahead for the rest of the casting team. Amongst those hoping to land a role in Britannia High were some known faces. X Factor finalist Ray Quinn.
It's definitely not what I expected.
Very engaging to watch. Yeah.
As well as Ray, Dance X winner Rana Roy.
I'm just like trying to keep up with everything, but it's going okay so far.
Yeah, she's a fantastic dancer and very good actress, and she's got a great personality. She walks in and you go, who's that? You know, that's a poster girl.
Like Arlene, the rest of the team were impressed with Sapphire Elia.
She's an all-rounder, isn't she?
So I think she's a real potential star. She can sing and she can dance and she can act.
But when it came to the final decision, no one could agree, and time was running out.
We've now seen an awful lot of
people. No, that's a very valid point.
And you've been through 200 to get here.
Yeah.
How many more hundreds
We've
are there?
We've hardly ever seen
How many more
voices
are there?
Like this.
We've got a lot of opinionated people working on this show, and I'm not convinced that some of the people we talked about today and strongly considered to put in the show have that special something for Britannia High.
The point is purely visual. The point, forget everything. Just look at what they look like.
Actually, I didn't think he looked 17. I think he looked 22. He looked like a man.
In the back of the producers' minds was the looming date with Gary Barlow. They needed singers.
If we cast Sapphire, you've got a singer. If we go with Ray, and there's a big discussion there, you've also got a singer.
Here to make sure they definitely cast people to work with Gary Barlow in Bath was ITV Network's commissioning editor of Britannia High, Paul Jackson.
I mean, I absolutely don't think that's the right casting.
As the man in charge of the overall series, it's his opinion that's final.
I'm just trying to cut through the chase, guys, because a lot of opinions in the room and a lot of interest.
You need to cast people who are super talented. That's what this show is about, super talent.
No one wanted to make a mistake. Getting the right cast was crucial, regardless of deadlines.
It's such a good opportunity for anyone, for any performer.
You just got to try your best, and if you're right for the part, you go. If you're not, yeah.
And after 3 hours, they were only happy to agree on just two performers.
Rana. Okay, thank you very much.
This is completely life-changing. I really didn't think I was going to cry. So I really did not expect that at all, and I'm so happy.
Rana Roy was our third star of Britannia High, and the fourth, Sapphire Elia. And with Sapphire away filming in Madrid, producer Gareth Phillips called her with the good news.
We would like you to be one of our main cast members in Britannia High.
Oh, my God.
I was, like, totally crazy. I couldn't believe it, to be honest. I was completely over the moon. I phoned everybody in my family, started crying to my nan down the phone.
They were now the next two cast members of Britannia High.
It's totally crazy. I can't believe it. It's great.
This is the best thing that has ever happened to me, and I'm so grateful.
January 2008, Bath. And Gary Barlow is already full steam ahead with writing the songs for ITV's new musical drama, Britannia High.
Not enough ups, but too many downs.
Not enough ups and too many downs.
Good.
Gary is one of Britain's top songwriters, and with a string of number one hits and awards with Take That, he's a legend in the pop world. And now he's charged with writing the new soundtrack for Britannia High.
I'm not gonna take this anymore. When I first heard about this, my plan was, get all these writers, brilliant people. I hadn't phoned a soul at this point. I had the A-list as, like, all the people I really, really wanted. Everyone I asked was just like, brilliant, love it, I'll see you there.
Gary had pulled together a dream team of writers and created a songwriting boot camp. Among them, Guy Chambers, who's best known for his work with Robbie Williams.
Let's do that again, yeah?
James Bourne from Busted, and Gary's bandmate from Take That, Mark Owen.
There's a really nice creative energy. It's a real pleasure to be a part of it.
Joining them are 14 more of the world's top songwriters. Together, they are responsible for songs that have sold hundreds of millions of records.
These guys, they're the biggest and best in the world. This is the way they did it in Motown. This is how it used to be. You know, we've turned back time a bit here. We're not doing anything new. We're just doing something that hasn't been done for a long time.
I don't wanna feel this anymore.
As Gary and the songwriters crack on with the soundtrack, in the hotel just down the road from the studios, Georgina, Matthew and Sophie are awaiting the arrival of the newest cast members. They have no idea of who or how many are joining them.
I can't wait to see who they bring through their door. And maybe, no, in my luck, I'll probably know them.
Arriving first is 21-year-old Sapphire Elia.
I'm just so excited to be here. I can't wait to meet everybody. And I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm really looking forward to it. I sort of had an inkling that maybe I'd see someone I knew. Turn the corner, and who do I see? Matt Thomas, who I went to school with.
Did you know?
How are you doing?
Oh my God!
I've known Sapphire for years. We were very close in school.
I did go out with him for like a couple of weeks.
We had like a very tiny little fling and she dumped me.
And he was like, I don't want to speak to you anymore. I've thrown your photo out of the window and all this kind of stuff, so. But I think it took about a year for him to get over it.
She hasn't changed much, but she's the same kind of, she's the same girl that I remember.
How embarrassing! I can't believe that he's, was it him that spilled the beans? It was. Oh, I'm gonna kill him. Let's move on.
Next to meet everyone is Rana Roy.
Hey, how you doing? Hey. How was your journey?
Good.
Nice to see you.
I was the last person to walk in and it was just, it was cool to see everyone.
Hey, I'm Sophie.
I'm Rana.
Hello. I'm always quite quiet and I keep myself to myself and let everyone do the talking and, you know, once you get to know me, I'm a bit louder and I'm more outgoing and whatever, but in the beginning, I'm always got a little wall up.
Everyone together and they're straight off to the recording studios to meet Gary.
Nice to meet you. And now that we're here, about to go into a studio with Gary Barlow, sort of a bit like, oh dear. It's real now.
Are you an actress or a singer or...?
A singer.
OK. Brilliant. That's what we need. More singers.
Sapphire, Matthew and Georgina now had to demonstrate their musical ability in front of everyone.
When the rain is pouring down... As I was singing, I was thinking, I can't believe all these amazing people are hearing me sing. They're listening to me. They want to hear my voice.
I was dreading almost hearing their voices because I thought, you know, we've got this big, serious team. Are they going to start singing? We all go, oh.
I don't make mistakes, they never happen to me.
I think everyone has been really relieved that actually the standard of the vocals has been so high.
There'd be nothing more to do.
My knees were knocking, and my paper, the paper with the lyrics on in my hand, was shaking, and I just thought, get a grip.
And for now, for Sophie and Rana, it was a chance to sit back and watch.
I was so, so proud of them. It was also the first time I'd heard them sing, so it was amazing. I was just watching there going, oh my God, you're amazing, I love it.
You're amazing.
Tomorrow's going to be a long day, I think, for them, because we're going to be getting them in the booth tomorrow, and it's going to be a bit nerve-wracking and hard work.
Over the next 2 weeks, the cast would be at the beck and call of all the songwriters to record vocals on the songs they had written.
Sapphire, she's just a beautiful, beautiful voice. No matter what, you can get her to sing I Like Eggs in the Morning and she makes it sound incredible, you know. Actually, that's a good lyric. Maybe I should go and work on that. I've got an idea for a song, lads.
On screen, the cast would be playing a group of friends, so the time to get to know one another was just as important as the singing.
Rana is really sweet. She's really funny as well.
I can't understand everything she says because of her accent.
From Cleethorpes, best fish and chips in the world.
I've never ever heard of Cleethorpes. Is that what it's called?
And with two boys yet to be cast, Matthew had all the girls to himself.
It's great. They're all stunning as well. They're all gorgeous girls.
I don't think he's looking forward to the two other guys turning up. I really don't. He's like, yeah, lapping up the attention. He loves it.
So with time running out, who would the final two boys be?
No, I'm really looking forward to finding out who they choose. So I'm intrigued.
Next time on Britannia High, wanted two boys who could sing, dance and act.
I believe I can fly.
The cast feel the pressure as day one of Britannia High filming looms.
I still haven't got the routine.
And the First Lady of Show Business has a word of warning.
These kids do not realise the hard work they're in for.
Britannia High is ITV's new high-octane drama with music by Gary Barlow. Set in a fictional performing arts school, the series follows the students of Britannia High. Danny, Lauren, Claudine, Bibi, Lola and Jez. This is the story of how the six stars of Britannia High were discovered and the year-long journey to create this exciting new series. Britannia High is a major new musical drama series created by Arlene Phillips.
That's where you start dancing from.
I think this project is going to be beyond anything I first dreamed of when I came up with the idea.
And theatre producer David Ian.
It's all starting to take shape. It's going to be a huge journey. That's what makes it very, very unique.
The story of Britannia High started a year ago when Arlene and David began their search for the six young, talented performers that were to become the new stars of the drama.
So you're the very, very first person out of this whole process. No pressure.
We're looking for triple threats. They've got to be able to sing, they've got to be able to dance, they've got to be able to act, and they've got to sort of burn through the screen. They've got to be stars.
So far, the producers had searched up and down the country for the very best young talent from the top performing arts schools.
We've seen a whole load of really good actors, really good singers, and I think we've seen a couple of good dancers, but they're not all necessarily in the same person.
She's a triple threat.
Yes.
Can't sing, can't dance, can't act.
After months of searching through hundreds of talented young performers, the casting team discovered four fantastic lead stars for Britannia High. They were Georgina Hagen.
I found my singer.
Matthew James Thomas. If I
was
30
seconds. Yeah, she's got a good voice, isn't she?
Sapphire Elia.
She's an all-rounder, isn't she?
Greetings.
Rana Roy.
That's a poster girl.
And an additional role for Sophie Powells.
She's absolutely lovely.
She's very, very special. Yeah.
She will be playing Ronnie in the Britannia High Canteen, a part created especially for her.
Just getting this part and being able to do this is just one big bonus, just a dream come true, really.
But they still needed to find two more lead stars to complete the cast.
I think we've set the benchmark so high now that we just don't want to make any mistakes.
Without the full cast, the whole production was in jeopardy and no one could afford for that to happen.
Yeah, I won't stop looking until we have to cast this week, otherwise we can't make the show.
So the pressure was on. If they didn't discover two boys who could sing, then it would be a disaster for lead songwriter Gary Barlow.
It's so important, those voices are essential.
It was now January 2008, Bath, and Gary Barlow had gathered a crack team of songwriters together to write the new soundtrack for Britannia High.
These guys, they're the biggest and best in the world. This is the way they did it in Motown. This is how it used to be.
Among the 16 songwriters enlisted by Gary are Guy Chambers.
Let's do that again, yeah?
Steve Lipson, Karen Poole, Steve Mack, James Bourne from Busted, and Gary's bandmate from Take That, Mark Owen.
I think everybody really wants it to be the best it can be, and nobody's holding back here. Everybody wants it to be really powerful.
Together, they're responsible for hit records for international stars like Whitney Houston, Kylie, Robbie Williams, Cher, Celine Dion, and countless others, and now Britannia High.
When you share that creativity at this level, means it will happen really quick. The best songs happen in 15 minutes. Back for Good, 15 minutes. That's how long that song took to write.
Yeah, good. As a character, as a sort of the centre of the group, he's the great all-rounder.
The songwriters were briefed each day by the producers of the show.
We've got writers from ITV and we've got all our music songwriters, and what we're trying to do is fuse them all together to make sure the song is really bespoke to the scene, and that's been the magic, the bit that's worked.
This is the week to try anything, isn't it?
We don't want the narrative of each one of these dramas to stop while we sing a song and then pick up the narrative. We want the songs to help propel the narrative.
As all the songs were being written especially for the characters, the five young performers that had already been cast were also in Bath to record their tracks.
Why do we do what we do, what we do?
Are you really gonna throw it all away?
I'm coming to terms with the fact that I've been lucky enough, you know, to be selected as one of the few people to be working with, you know, these great songwriters. And I still kind of can't believe that I'm a part of it.
There's no love in a fight song.
It's called the fight song. It's quite chanty.
Are you really gonna throw it all away?
You have to tell Matthew not to sing quite as well as you normally do, you know.
Oh,
I think he's enjoying it. I think he's enjoyed singing it, and he's got a great voice. Frightening. He's been well cast. Apart from me, not being in it.
I feel like I've realised where I belong. I'm having the time of my life.
16-year-old Georgina Hagen is used to working with musicians. Her dad is a musical director and her mum is a West End star.
I never thought that I'd be here today doing what I'm doing. Not in a million years. But now I'm here and I feel like it's my time to shine.
She's about to record a new track that Gary has written with Elliot Kennedy, Gary Goh and James from Busted.
I am really nervous and I've just got to go in there and do it all myself. The whole experience is already it's better than I expected already, and I can just see it getting better and better and better.
As Georgina worked late into the night on her vocals, Sapphire was recording another Gary Barlow track in the main studio.
This is a song he has written for me, not anybody else. And like you're in the moment and you're like really enjoying it, that is. And the next second you're like, oh my God, it's Gary Barlow. No one in my family is into the business at all. I'm the only one. I've just always been dancing and singing and running around and a real extrovert. My mum used to hold the camera up to my face and I'd go and grin with these two little teeth at the front.
She's actually got a very advanced voice. Really got it now. Could you mind if we do one more? Because it sounds so good. She's learnt a song in about 10 minutes. We've spent an hour doing vocals and it's really very, very good.
The cast worked non-stop for 2 weeks on their solo and group vocals.
None of us even want to leave this studio tonight. We're like, no, we want to stay and do more. Can we stay and do more?
It's been good for them to be around the birth of these songs, which they're going to be singing for probably a few years, I hope.
Gary and his team had produced an incredible 30 potential tracks for Britannia High.
From this point, there's another couple of gears now, so it'll sound even better. It's been just incredible.
It was now the end of the songwriting boot camp, and Arlene came to listen to what Gary had created.
I'm here. God, look at this studio. Oh. I've been travelling the country, and all I've done is hold my schedule out every day and look when I could get a day off to go to Bath.
I love seeing Gary Barlow, so excited.
Get me the music. As I listen to the music, pictures form in my mind. The music is so phenomenal. Oh my God.
It's great, isn't it?
I just couldn't believe it. It's inspirational.
And when she heard the big ballad, Proud, Arlene was moved to tears.
I had the wind taken out of my sails. This song is so beautiful, it's absolutely painful.
The song had been written for one of the characters that, as yet, had not been cast.
We have to find the boy that can sing it.
Arlene now had to turn her thoughts to how they would find the missing two boys.
The search is on, no stone unturned, the message is out, and we are going to look for everyone that can possibly do this. And we won't stop until we do. I know we'll find them. They are there.
March 2008, Manchester. And the desperate search was on to find the elusive two boys needed to complete the cast of Britannia High. It was critical. If the casting team didn't find potential talent in this final search, it could put the whole series in jeopardy.
For my money, I won't stop looking until we're faced with under deadline of we have to cast this week, otherwise we can't make the show.
They came from all over.
I came up last night from Swansea, South Wales.
Hoping to land a part in Britannia High.
I've done acting all my life, I've done singing all my life. I'm not too fond of dance, but I'll do it if I'm told what I'm doing.
But one by one, they were rejected.
Thank you for coming.
The producers had a clear idea of what they wanted and quickly eliminated boys that didn't have that all-important Britannia High magic.
Actually looking for is singers.
No, I know.
When you believe I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet like sky.
With Gary Barlow's songs already written, they had to find great voices.
I believe I can fly.
It was to be a frustrating day for the producers. No one came close to what they were looking for until Markelle Ward auditioned.
Can I just make some more?
That's the first one today, Christy, yeah. I think.
The casting team liked his voice.
Cool, that's great, Markelle.
And were even more impressed with his dancing.
Today I was sitting down thinking, oh, this is another waste of time. And young Markelle walked in and lifted our spirits because you suddenly see somebody and you think, oh, if he turns out to be one of our cast and he's the only thing we got out of today, then today's worth it.
But this was only the first step. Now Markelle faced an audience with Arlene Phillips and David Ian in a further audition in London. March 2008, and Markelle Ward has come to London. If he impresses today, then he could land one of the lead roles in Britannia High. It's make or break for him.
My heart's all the way in it and everything's in it, and I'm like, yo, I need to do this.
As well as holding open auditions, the producers also looked at young performers from talent agencies and found someone they were very excited about, 17-year-old Mitch Hewer.
Mitch has been in a show called Skins. Very talented, good-looking guy.
My acting experience is through Skins. I've filmed Skins for probably 2 years now. Yeah, looking for something new to do now, and hopefully this may be it.
But Mitch's previous TV experience wouldn't guarantee him a role. Just like Markelle, he too was going to have to work for it. Following a grueling audition, it was crunch time. To make it into Britannia High, they would need Arlene and David's final seal of approval.
David and Arlene are going to turn up for an hour today and cast their eyes over these two and tell us what they think. Hopefully they like them and that this process will be over.
I watched Arlene on Strictly Come Dancing, so I was a bit worried when she was coming in, but I spotted her and I was like, oh my God.
I was like, uh-oh, I know that voice. And when I turned around, I was like, oh boy, how long has she been there? I was like, please say she only just got here.
Pull your trousers down, get straight up. Yeah. Can you watch here? George is going up and down. Markelle needs a lot of work. What he doesn't have is technique, but he's got a great personality.
And you just need to go, I don't give a damn, I'm just in the street.
I think Mitch is a teen idol. His dance is interesting. It is not born of training or technique, but it is a captivating way of moving. And he's got a smile that just lights up a room, you know, and you can't buy those.
David Ian has been watching the auditions closely.
What we haven't had up till now, as far as I'm concerned, is our great-looking poster boy. And I think Mitch has just walked in the room and that's who he is. This is exactly what we needed. Two guys that can really dance, really sing, and most importantly, really act. It's fantastic, isn't it?
With David and Arlene happy, had they finally found the missing two pieces of the Britannia High jigsaw?
It was hard, it was intense. If I got this, oof, this is a turning point.
Today's been absolutely amazing, and if I could get the part and know that, like, every day is going to be like today, it's going to be wicked.
The thing that both boys have is a unique quality, and that thing that makes you want to watch them, and they both got that, and David and Arlene both said that today.
The boys had done all they could. They would now have to wait before they were told whether they were in or out.
You know, it's made me want it even more, and I just want it now.
It's been a week since Markelle Ward and Mitch Hewer auditioned.
I would be gutted if I didn't get it. I think I tried quite hard.
I don't want it, I need it.
They are about to find out the decision. First, Markelle.
Hey, Markelle, it's Gareth
Phillips and Brian Grant here from Britannia High.
Hey, how you doing?
How are you?
Thanks for so much incredible work and really good your role. And
Brian and I have come to the decision that
we'd like to cast you in the show.
Yo!
And then Brian called Mitch, who was waiting for the call with his parents in Bristol.
Thank you for all the work you did and that day when you worked very hard for this show.
Yeah, it's totally fine.
I just wondered if you'd like to be a member of the cast.
Yeah! Oh, my God, yeah.
They were now the two final cast of Britannia High.
Yes! Yes!
Proud of you.
Now the real work started. Sheffield, May 2008. And only a few weeks after finding out they were cast, Mitch and Markel were thrown right in at the deep end as they met up with Georgina Hagen and headed to the studios to record vocals for Britannia High.
It is quite nerve-wracking. I've never really been in a studio. I'm kind of excited and, like, overwhelmed as well.
It's like everyone knows what they're doing, and myself and Mitch, we was like, we feel like we're the newbies.
That's gonna be crazy.
But all we can do, to be honest, is keep up, show what we can do, and rise to the occasion.
They will be working with high-profile music producer Elliot Kennedy.
I've had a varied career, from working with artists like the Spice Girls and S Club 7 and Billy Piper to Bryan Adams, Aretha Franklin and Celine Dion. 8 million.
But that is Celine, though. I mean, she is a legend.
I've done just about everything I've done in this studio.
I was just shocked, because I seen that disc of Celine Dion was the first thing I saw, and I was like, this guy is a genius if you work with her.
It's going to be awesome knowing that some hot chick from S Club 7 wore the same headphones as I'm going to be putting on my head. That's so cool.
Oh, my God, Billy Piper.
It's the first time in a recording studio for Mitch and Markel.
So where are you going to be doing your vocal takes?
Well, this is a big move, you know. Welcome to the days of the move where it's like, this is nice.
For music producer Elliot, it was time to create the finished tracks for the series.
We're now at the point where there is 17 songs chosen for the album. It's just a great collection of really cool contemporary pop songs. So I think, you know, regardless of who's written and produced them, they're going to be hit records. They just sound too good.
Having only just met, this was the first time the boys had heard Georgina sing.
OK, just sing for me, sweetie.
I don't wanna hear it anymore.
I mean, George, she's amazing. She went in the booth when we first heard her full voice. I was like, oh, my word, are we going after that?
George's voice is so good. So, so good. She's, like, very talented.
Georgie is one of the best, kind of straight-up pop singers. She can just make your song sound like it's been on the radio all year.
Now I know.
With Georgina's vocals in the can, it was Markel's turn at the mic.
My heart was pounding at a speed that I've never actually witnessed it pound before. It hit me as if to say, this is real now, this is happening, because we're playing catch-up. I mean, my brain's like, all right, well, anything anyone says, absorb, get it back out as quick as you can.
I'll talk you through the phrase now. Yeah, that falling, you know. He's got an incredible feel, you know, his pocket, you know, the feel that he sings in was just really cool.
Working with Elliot, he's a cool guy. I mean, he's one of the boys now, man.
That's right. That's cool, man. Let's go one more, because I'm digging this new vibe.
For him to say to me on the recording that I had a good vocal, I was like, what?
Wicked. Thanks, man. Wicked vocals, man. That was great.
He could have just said OK and I'd have been happy.
Come on, dude. Still on.
Next, Mitch has to show off his vocals.
Feeling great?
I don't know what my voice would bring to the group. Charm. Charisma.
Now I know where to go.
What I did with Mitch is just said to him, look, this is the character you're singing on behalf of. And the vocal delivery, I could hear his smile, I could hear the cheekiness, the delivery of it. That's the difference with working with these characters. Wicked. And again, man.
And now I know.
Remember that attitude?
Yeah.
Being here in the recording studio today is it's wicked. And, you know, I can't wait to get on set, start dancing, acting, singing, and, you know, putting it all together with all the guys.
Cool, thank you. Mitch and Markel were just amazing. You know, they've just come into this thing completely cold, completely gotten into character and delivered. You know, I've already started recording and they sound fantastic.
So far, only Georgina had met newly cast Mitch and Markel.
I was really excited to meet Mitch and Markel because kind of really looking forward to having some sort of bonding time and just really get to know them.
The following day, they were joined by the rest of the Britannia High cast, Sapphire Elia, Rana Roy and Matthew James Thomas.
It's really great to finally have some guys here.
We was like, uh-oh, will we get along? Will they like us? And
they all sing all the time.
And I know Matt's definitely happy that there's boys here and he can have a little guy moment and whatever.
So Matt, he's fun, he can sing. He's a great guy to be around.
Mitch is definitely the joker of the group.
Which is really nice. We've got on like two peas in the pod.
We are now this kind of little crew and we're the BH gang.
I do feel Britannia High is coming together. I mean, everything now is so, like, real.
As time goes on, I'm feeling even luckier and getting more excited about, you know, the outcome and stuff.
I'm like, all systems go.
A gruelling schedule lay ahead of them. More recordings, choreography, photo shoots and rehearsals, all leading up to the first day on set.
This is my life for the next 6 months.
London, May, 1 month to go, and the cast are warming up for their first group dance session with co-creator and choreographer of Britannia High, Arlene Phillips.
I had butterflies when I woke up this morning because this was the real thing.
This is the first time Arlene will be teaching them the dance routines for the series.
I don't know, you know, are they really up to it? Here we are, first day of rehearsal.
The schedule is already a week behind, leaving the cast little time to perfect their dance routines. But even under pressure, Arlene is still expecting great things.
She demands perfection and she'll get perfection out of you, so she will be tough with you.
I know what Arlene's choreography is like and it's not easy.
This is the moment I was dreading.
They couldn't afford at this late stage to fall short of Arlene's high standards.
They cannot imagine how much work they have to do. We have 2 weeks to choreograph 6 numbers.
It's hard choreography, but that's what I wanted anyway, to test myself, which is good.
Those aren't great shoes to dance in.
They're going to have to be working night and day. It's going to be relentless.
I'm feeling OK here today. I don't know if it's going to change. I'll be picking my hair out by the end of the week.
It's been really hard work, basically. And I still haven't got the routine.
I'm quite concerned about Sapphire. She really hasn't had a lot of dance training, but she's just going to have to think herself a dancer. There is no time to deal with the way she feels about her dancing. She's just going to have to get on with it.
As each of the 6 cast will be playing different roles in the drama, Arlene wants them to focus on their characters.
Well, I want you to try to just go away and just show me 2 moves through dance and what way expresses your character.
Markel will play streetwise BB.
I'm going to give him some street elements, some locking and popping to show off what BB does. And he needs that cool edge.
Markel was amazing. I literally was like,
5, 6, 7,
and Rana is Lola, our star dance pupil.
I think I don't really have to change my style of dancing because she's quite girly and sexy and, yeah, show off a bit.
Mitch, who plays Danny, is a cheeky joker with a secret.
I want to do it to the best of my ability. I want to push myself to, like, the next level. I just want to get something else out of myself.
What you can say with your body is quite extraordinary. From here on in, I want you to feel confident, take it easy and really focus.
I'm focused, I'm in the zone. Joking stops in class. It's not going to be. No, you won't see me joking in class. Or you will.
Sapphire is Claudine, the girl who's used to getting what she wants.
Although Claudine's been dancing her whole life, she's never really concentrated enough on the actual dance in itself. She's more kind of about me, 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 look at me.
Georgina plays Lauren, who's talented but lacks self-confidence.
I am like Lauren a lot, because around Rana and Markel and Mitch, I'm very sort of insecure about how I dance and what I look like.
And finally, Matt is Jez, the posh boy who lives to perform.
I kind of dropped dancing before I got this job and I was like, you know what, I'm just going to concentrate on my acting, but I feel like I'm picking it up.
But this was only day one. They would now be working on Arlene's dance routines every day for the next 4 weeks.
I don't think any of our Britannia High chosen ones have got any idea of how tough this is really going to be. They're never going to wake up and feel good, ever again.
It's now late May 2008, and the cast are heading north. As Britannia High will be filmed in Manchester, they all have to relocate. For 16-year-old Georgina, the youngest member of the cast, it's a big move.
First time away from home. I don't know what I'm going to do.
She'll have to say goodbye to her mum and her dog, Finley.
I love being home. I really love being home. I don't like being away from it at all.
I'll miss her singing. I'll miss her mess in her bedroom.
But she has something special to take with her.
This is where it gets really embarrassing. My blanket, which I've had since I was in hospital, 9 months old. I keep it under my pillow when I sleep.
because I feel like if I don't have it, I feel really lost without it.
She's really, really close to me and we're really, really good friends. I will miss her being around.
Georgina and the rest of the cast will be away from home for 6 months.
I think it's going to be really weird moving to Manchester. I feel like it is a new step.
Time to get acquainted with their new homes.
Oh my God!
Sophie will be playing Ronnie. She's not a student at Britannia High, but works in the school canteen.
Got some tea bags?
Sophie has moved down from hometown Cleethorpes and is Georgina's roommate.
And I like to mother everyone and make sure everyone's all right, so I'll look after her and make sure she's settled and stuff. High five, Georgie, high five.
High five for that, mate.
I am gutted that I've got the small room. I don't want the small room. And she's got an ensuite. She's not using that bathroom. That's my ensuite. I'm telling you now. Baths are going to be a rare occasion for Ron.
Manchester, May 2008. The set of Britannia High is almost built, and with only 9 days before the cast start shooting their first scenes, they have a brief tour of where they will spend most of the next 6 months.
It's better than what I imagined, especially where we're going to be staying and stuff.
I won't be cooking in it yet because it ain't quite ready, but be exciting because that's where most of my scenes are at the minute.
After the tour, they are taken straight to costume to discover their character's taste in clothes.
I'm hoping it's trendy.
Would anyone actually wear this?
Yeah. Are they mine?
Oh, very slow walking.
Yeah.
I think it'd look good.
Yeah.
I could wear this easy.
It's nice.
Bit of mash, pie. I'll get into my character when I get my tabard on, because I don't want Ronnie to be me, I want it to be different.
After trying on these outfits, it's not hard at all to separate Lola from Rana.
OK, that's not going to happen.
My name's Jez.
What do I look like?
This is my chef's outfit, my chef white.
I want that T-shirt. Can I have it?
Are we all going to have our names around our
necks?
No, names?
Just you.
Claudine.
So the characters of Lola, Lauren, Bibi, Jez, Claudine, Danny and Ronnie were all starting to look the part. Now, it was critical that they started to really become their characters.
To know that shoot day is in a week's time, we're like, oh, it's official. So I can't wait. And it has been a blessing, so I am proud to be here and so thankful.
The following day, and all the executive producers, writers and cast of Britannia High are together for the first script read-through.
It's been quite a relentless process so far, and now's when the hard work starts.
Now is the time the scripts Jonathan Harvey and the rest of the scriptwriters have been toiling over for months start to come to life.
It's really important for the writer to be at the read-through to hear, you know, what's getting laughs, what's working, what's interesting and what's boring.
Oh, and
and it's always slightly embarrassing when jokes you think people are going to laugh at, they don't.
It's a daunting moment for the young cast, too.
Even if you didn't think you were going to get nervous, as soon as all the people were in the room, you started shaking, you're like, oh, God, I can't believe I'm doing this.
I'm always terrified that people are going to think, you know, if I make one mistake, that they're going to think, oh, God, you know, have we cast?
The show's writers have tried to draw on aspects of the cast's real lives and put them into the drama.
I think they've really, really studied us and watched us without us really knowing. And they're really building the characters around us, which is such a privilege.
As the cast get to grips with their characters, the similarities are becoming clear.
Danny's the cheeky chappy, who's good at pulling the birds and all the girls' fancy.
Danny is quite a lot like me, actually. He's scarily a lot like me. You know, he's kind of the person that thinks that every girl loves him to death. I would say I was a little bit of, maybe, heart thump. I mess about a lot like Danny as well. I have a lack of concentration like Danny, and obviously we're going to both look like each other. Oh my God, that was so stupid to say.
Hey, I'm Danny.
And I like fit girls. And none of you lots are mingers, so do you get me?
Yeah, I see a lot of myself in Claudine. I never used to. I think I was in denial about it.
I want my name up there with the greats. Mariah, Celine.
She's a perfectionist like me in a lot of ways. She enjoys the hard work and she's really ambitious and stuff.
I do see parts of me in Lauren. My vulnerability towards situations where it comes to showing off my talent.
Oh, that
There's people judging me, expecting me to fail.
I don't see them.
Because I always feel a little bit intimidated by everyone else.
Lauren is more sort of, she's the sort of everyman character. She's the one, particularly in episode one, that hopefully the audience identify with as being slightly a fish out of water in this world of high kicking and back flipping.
Lola lives in her own little world.
I want to be a super dancer.
She's always in a bubble. She says things as she's thinking it.
I just need the audience's constant reassurance that,
hey, I'm okay. I think Jez is the character that everyone would always turn to for a shoulder to cry on.
There's Bibi, who's the sort of mean, moody, quiet one with a, you know, a troubled backstory.
He's found, like, a link with Jez. They come from totally different worlds, but they're so right together. They're like a comedy duo.
Britannia High was taking shape, a fictional performing arts school for exceptionally talented students.
No one really wants to be in a normal school. Everyone wants to be at Britannia High. And it's just a place where you're kind of living your dream, and it's a process of making that dream happen.
There seems to be a fame epidemic in this country where everybody on the street thinks that they're entitled to be famous if they want to be. This show isn't really about that. It's about kids who are really, really talented and who are in the top sort of 5% of their age group for what they do.
Sophie, who plays Ronnie in the series, can only dream of being one of those talented students.
Working in a canteen is the closest thing she can get to being at Britannia High, because in her mind, I'm still at Britannia High. I might be working in the kitchen, but I'll work in the kitchen well.
For Arlene Phillips, one of the creators of Britannia High, today was the day her vision took one huge step forward.
One of the most amazing moments in the read-through was there's a little scene when Georgie calls her mother.
Oh, Mum, it's me. Sorry to miss you.
And just listening to her, watching her, I was really sort of moved at the way she did it.
I guess you're all right. Listen, I might be coming home on Friday.
And that was the moment when it all became real. You know, you come up with an idea and suddenly it's there. It's about to go on screen.
It was less than a week to the start of filming. As well as rehearsing dance routines, recording their vocals and learning their scripts, for Matthew, Sapphire, Georgina and Mitch, it was time for a new look.
Whoever cuts my hair, I always find something to wear, even if it's good.
It's weird seeing your hair in your hand and not on your head.
I just thought, you know, they'd be happy with my hair. But how wrong was I?
I have seen a picture. I like the picture, but in all honesty, I don't think the length of that will suit me.
Does it look good?
I kind of like it already.
Absolutely love the colour, I love the cut.
Oh, I love it. Oh, it's so good. I'm so happy.
With their hair, makeup and styling now complete, the cast were about to have their first photo shoot.
Well, today we're in a school in Manchester using their gymnasium for a photo shoot. Generally quite a lot of fun with, like, jumping up and down on trampolines and stuff.
We're trying to show what Britannia High is all about, the excitement that we've got in, the passion we love. And it's going to be a press release, so it's going to be on billboards and buses around the country.
I'm all glammed up, as you can see. I'm in a very dramatic Claudine outfit. It's just really good fun.
I'm on top of the star, trying to dance, with a wind machine blowing in my hair, and I've got pants and heels on, so I'm trying not to fall over with the wind machine and the heels and on top of the star. So, it's quite funny, but I love it.
It's harder for the other guys than it is for me, because, like, Rana's doing back bends and Michael's doing, you know, freeze stills on his hands, and I'm just, like, going, woo, look at me. I'm posing as Claudine, because Claudine likes to be the centre of attention. It's quite funny, actually, he happens to be like...
The following day, and they were back in the dance studio for more rehearsals.
And one, two... three, four.
With just 3 days before the cameras start to roll on the drama, the tough regime was starting to take its toll.
Well, the schedule's really kicking down on us now, and we're... it's quite hard, you know. Literally, I go home and I fall asleep.
It's really hard to keep up with everything and know that we've got to do acting, singing and dancing at the same time.
If that wasn't pressure enough, Arlene had come to Manchester.
Today is really important because it's almost D-Day.
I think Arlene will still push us. She'll never settle.
Nope.
She'll always keep pushing us so that we get better and better.
When Arlene first saw the cast dancing a month ago, she had some concerns.
I'm quite concerned about Sapphire. She really hasn't had a lot of dance training, but she's just going to have to think herself a dancer. There is no time to deal with the way she feels about her dancing. She's just going to have to get on with it.
As Sapphire had been away recording vocals, she had fallen behind with her dance rehearsals.
The other night, I literally came back from Sheffield at 10 p.m. and they were going over the dance routines that they'd done in the day and I'd missed out on. And I don't know how I'm going to pick up that routine. That's another story altogether. But I just sat there like, I'm so tired, I cannot lift a finger, let alone do a dance routine.
Could she now prove to Arlene that she had done enough?
Today I was a bit worried because I thought, oh no, she's going to make me go through all the routines and I'm going to just like forget them all.
Don't be afraid to sort of be sitting there. Forget about the back bend. You're there and then you're going to go down the back.
I feel that I've come a long way with dancing big time. I've worked so hard, hardest I've ever worked. It definitely paid off.
I think Sapphire's come a long, long way. She actually can dance. She's improved enormously. I didn't think she would do what she's doing. Big step, big leap. But she has to go on working. It can't stop here.
If I tell you bum's sticking out, it's sticking out.
In the early rehearsals, Rana stood out as one of the best dancers. But Arlene is now worried about her fitness.
I want you every day to be doing 100 sit-ups and get your strength back.
Arlene is... she's harsh. She's harsh.
Nobody had what you had. Don't become ordinary, because you were absolutely untouchable.
Yeah.
And don't be ordinary.
I won't, I promise.
Get back in that training. Get back what you had.
You have to take it as constructive criticism and you just have to, she wants you to be the best and that's what we're aiming to be.
Everyone's worked really, really hard. I think I'm just a very demanding taskmaster and nothing's ever good enough.
With only a few days before they will be performing this routine on set, a frustrated Arlene gives the Britannia High gang a harsh dose of reality.
You have to be here because you want to dance. You've got this weekend to get passionate about it, because from Monday, that's what I'm expecting to see. You've got to want it. You've got to want to go into class. You've got to want to listen to the teachers.
I always think, like, people like Arlene, kind of like kind of dance teachers, that always pick on you. But they only pick on you for good reason, I believe. Kind of, they want you to be the best.
She works so hard, and I think when we finally come to film it, she'll be there saying, no, do it again, no, do it again, until she's happy.
Our cast have come a long way. Have they come far enough? Well, only Monday will tell.
It's 8 a.m. Manchester, the 9th of June 2008, and the cast are just arriving on set.
Bit of a getting up early this morning.
This is their very first day of filming on Britannia High.
I don't know, I woke up this morning, like, I kind of prepared myself for 5 minutes, I opened my eyes and just thought, right, it's time to start.
The last 8 months have been building to this day.
It has been a really long journey up to this point because of all the dancing and all the rehearsing and you know, trying to get everything right. I'm looking forward to actually getting on set.
We've been waiting for it to happen for so long and it's finally here.
I think everyone's quite excited and getting ready. Everyone's more ready than I am.
Everything that we've done so far has been built up for this day and, wow, there's a lot of pressure on.
Really excited about starting today. It all comes down to this.
I'm really pleased with the cast we've got. I think we couldn't have found better, and it was one of the hardest castings that I think any of us have ever been involved in. And I really think that they and this show are going to really demonstrate what it means to be the best of British.
On set, series producer and director Brian Grant is making last-minute checks.
Everybody's been anticipating this for a long time, and really, this is the most creative part of it. It's the bit I love the most.
Today, all the cast will be filming in the Students' Cafe.
We are shooting Confessions, which is where Markel sings to his brother. We're all having a little dance in the den.
Today, I'm going to be doing a load of butt flips and summies and everything, but I don't know how I'm feeling, you know, because nothing's kicking in at the moment. I'm very calm.
This is the dance that I dread. I'm with Matt, who's a fantastic partner, but I just feel like I let him down a little bit.
It's so fluffy.
It's a really easy start for me. I'm really, really lucky. Everyone's warming up right now and I'm just kind of like sitting in my dressing gown.
Rehearsal's over, everyone was ready. But just as the cameras were about to roll, disaster struck. The the special effects smoke machine that triggered the fire alarm.
Literally, in our places about to do the first take, and it just went doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
Oh, it adds a little bit of drama to Britannia High.
Half an hour later, everyone was back on set and ready to finally start. Here, the story of the creation of Britannia High begins a new chapter as the cast and production team get underway with producing this long-awaited drama series. It's been a hell of a journey to this point. The six new stars of Britannia High have come a long way since their first audition. At times, it was tough for them and the casting team.
You need to cast people who are super talented. That's what this show's about, super talent.
Is she a kind of character that you'd want to see every week?
Incredible talent is what Britannia High is about.
They were chosen from over 1,000 of the most talented young performers across Britain in a monumental search to find the show's stars.
The people that we'd like to offer a part in Britannia High are Matthew Thomas.
I can't believe it.
Georgina Hagen.
Oh my God!
I can't believe it.
Rana.
This is the best thing that has ever happened to me.
I was like, I couldn't believe it.
If I got this, oof, this is a turning point.
We'd like to cast you in the show.
If I could get the part and know that every day is going to be like today, it's going to be wicked.
Proud of you.
My dad is going to be so proud of me.
As he should be.
Future for me is a bit blooming exciting, but I've got a lot of hard work to do now.
It has been a punishing and relentless schedule, but the sweat, tears and the endless rehearsals have all been worth it, because now they were ready.
Britannia High is absolutely ready and raring to go, and I'm there with it.
And here's a taster of what's to come as the doors open to Britannia High. The most eagerly anticipated drama series of the year is set in a fictional performing arts school for exceptionally talented students.
I want my name up there with the greats. Madonna, Claudine.
Starring Mark Benton as school principal, Mr. Nugent.
Don't be a wannabe, be who you want to be.
Adam Garcia as dance teacher, Stefan.
You have the makings of a great dancer.
And of course, the six lead stars.
Pick it up for the letter L.
Georgina Hagen is Lauren.
You're the only one who believed in me.
Mitch Hewer is Danny.
I stand the women already falling at my feet.
Well, ladies, looks like we've got a fight on our hands.
Sapphire Elia plays Claudine.
I'd lend you something amazing to wear, but I don't think we're the same size.
Markel Ward is Bibi.
What tights there? Tight, man.
I think it's called streamlining.
Matthew James Thomas is Jez.
Hi, hi, ladies. Hi.
Lola. Audience. Audience, Lola.
And Rana Roy is Lola.
I'm a fan. Number one fan.
I want to be super dancer.
As we follow their highs and lows as the story unfolds at Britannia High.
I'll drop dead, Claudine.
I know what I need to do now.
Bye.
place I'd rather be. Listen to the voice inside of me.